learning here in the 21st century. And we're joined by Dr. Mike Fulton, superintendent, Pattonville School District, Dr. Eric Knost, superintendent, Rockwood School District, and from the Union School District, it's Dr. Steve Weinhold, who is the super down there. Mike, let's start with you when we talk about accreditation. And for our people listening, like I said, that are just driving around in their cars, why should accreditation matter to them, and what does that mean to them?
Well, accreditation matters because that determines whether or not you have a good school district in the public's eye. And so one of the things that we're working on right now is trying to redesign Missouri's accreditation and assessment systems. What does that mean? Well, with the passage of Every Student Succeeds Act, which was recently signed by Congress and the President, Missouri now has an opportunity to take a look at how it accredits its schools and how we do our assessments with kids and make it a lot better. And a lot better looks like this. When students take a test in grades 3 through 8 in math and in English language arts, basically they get a test that they take in April and they don't get feedback from that test for months. You don't have to do it that way. I think there's freedom under the Every Student Succeeds Act to redesign our Missouri assessment to where kids can use this as a feedback loop for them on how they're doing in their learning and really begin to be the audience for the assessment versus having, the test being used to make sure that you're complying with certain things that the state or federal government requires.
Eric, is that a common complaint for administrators, kind of like how we gauge how we're doing in a sense?
It is. And we're in a system that very much feels a lot of times, whether it is or it isn't in all aspects, it feels like the tail's wagging the dog because it comes down to that accreditation being related to the almighty test score. And while we know accountability is important, we would never deny that. We want accountability. But we can't get away from the idea of kids needing to learn and that genuine, authentic learning, which, you know, this leads into some of the things that I had mentioned, the experiential learning piece, getting kids more involved in what they learn how to do and being things with hands-on, being out in the field, having real experiences with maybe what their passion is, what their career is going to be. Industry loves the idea of kids having hands-on opportunities. But we're so caught up in the accreditation model and making sure that we make the grade, so to speak. Because whether you mentioned earlier to the parents driving around listening, a lot of them understand surface level about the accreditation piece, and a lot of what they know is what gets printed in the newspaper the day after test scores come out, and how'd this district do, how'd that district do. And that puts a lot of pressure. It's one thing for the pressure to be on us as administrators, but the teachers in the classroom, who are the content experts, it drives a lot of what they do and how we teach kids.
So, and it seems to me, Steve, and it's probably a better term for it, but it's almost like CYA, cover your rear, like everybody got a great score, but did they really get prepared for life or the working world?
Right, and that really goes back to what Eric and Mike have said. When we go to a standards-based world where we're trying to look at what each student knows on each standard versus what do they know is what that B in math means. What does a B in math mean? What does a B for a school district mean? What's that 80% or 70%? So now we look at each standard. We see if a kid understands fractions. They understand how to add fractions, multiply fractions. We also can do with hands-on experience situations that Eric talked about as well. So it's really about bringing it all together and looking at the focus of the child all the way up through the whole district.
We kind of miss the idea of knowledge being applied to something. It's one thing to regurgitate information on a fill-in-the-bubble test or what have you, but the ability to apply knowledge to those experiential pieces, it's where we need to go in the future.
Get into real-world activities.
Mm-hmm. And are we seeing more of that, or is part of the pushback, well, we still got to make sure we get the classwork and you're still book smart? Is there still, they got to be able to pass the test? Is that the balance we're talking about?
There's tremendous pressure, particularly for school districts that work with students in poverty, to do well on the test. Because at the end of the day, that's what matters in the public eye. And that's okay. It's good that they do well on the test. But that's one event at one time of the year in a child's life. It doesn't represent all of what the child learned. And I think more importantly, because all 8-year-olds have to take the same test in April. Not all 8-year-olds entered third grade at the same point. And it doesn't accommodate for the fact that you may have kids walking in 2 to 3 grade levels below that aren't ready to take that test. And the system isn't really designed to incentivize school districts to change the way that they teach kids to make sure that kids get to grade level expectations by some point before high school. When we were in school, we'd sit in a classroom, everybody would be there for the same amount of time, right? We all sat through third grade together. We all learned the same content together. And we did that because it was efficient, but it wasn't necessarily effective. Some kids needed more challenge. Some kids needed a longer period of time than just third grade to learn. Right now, the system doesn't incentivize districts making the kinds of accommodations that we need to for kids to make sure that all kids learn. So in the old model, it was time was a constant, learning was a variable. If you didn't learn it, you still moved on. But when we look ahead, that changes. The learning standard is constant. We want kids to be ready for high school, all kids. But the amount of time that it will take kids to get there will vary. Some are ready for high school content at early ages. Some, when they reach high school age, are still getting the foundations in place to effectively learn high school content. We need to acknowledge that and design the system so all kids are effective in their learning.
And how do you guys are smart guys, how do we better gauge how we're doing then? How do we, if you take away that standard test that everybody takes, how do you then come out with a grade for your district?
Yeah. That obviously has to be developed and considered, and something has to be authentic. But I wanted to back up really quick. You had mentioned the balance of the experiential piece. There's a lot of talk and a lot of people excited about STEM, you know, science, technology, engineering, math, and the arts are in there as well. That's really helped, I think, the movement more into the experiential piece, because that's more conducive to that concept. So people understand that, and there's a big push for that from industry and higher ed, and it's kind of paving the way. But there's a real continuum for the concept of experiential learning. I mean, everything from kids on a job site doing actual work down to just activities in a classroom that are more hands-on, more project-based. So there's a continuum, and there's such a thing as bad experiential learning too, that you know, doesn't give us the opportunity to assess what the kids know and what they can do. So it's a journey that we're still on, but we're moving in that direction.
Even getting rid of like shop, did we overthink it? Because that has
not all of us have.
Okay, no. Okay. So shop does still exist.
Oh, yes. Yes. More in the technology world now, because we're using more computers involved inside those shop classes at this time. Mm-hmm.
But even in Rockwood, we have dirty shops.
In some
of our schools.
On the how do you do this? Well, MASA has a task force that's working on giving specific recommendations to the state board on how to redesign the accreditation system and the assessment system to really incentivize districts to make sure that they're taking care of all learners and that they're being encouraged to innovate, to find creative solutions that work, that in fact have kids doing exactly the kinds of things that Steve and Eric are talking about. So that's kind of exciting. We're all working hard on connecting to industry and making sure that kids are in fact life ready and career ready as best we can, including getting industry certifications before they leave high school.
It's a fascinating topic. We could talk for hours. Unfortunately, the school bell is about to ring. Dr. Mike Fulton is the superintendent at the Pattonville School District. Dr. Eric Knost, superintendent, Rockwood School District. And Dr. Steve Weinholt, superintendent in Union School District. Gentlemen, thanks for being here.